To check if it was fit for show on one display or multiple. Oh, geez. Yeah. Alright, so while he's talking, I'll bring the sound to the player, and we'll have the mute and try a couple and then go to the other 9 yards. Alright. I'm gonna go let Chris know that you got it.
You would know.
Once he actually thought of it, we're like, oh my gosh, are you kidding me?
Thank you. Pocket City for the roof.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Our community is awesome. We just want to say thank you.
Y'all are awesome.
On behalf of Evans Children Academy, we want to say thank you.
Thank you, Pocket City for the roof.
Thank you to Pocket City for the roof.
Thank you, Pocket City, so much. Thank you, Pocket City for the roof.
Staff and our dream team of volunteers, we want to thank the patrons of the Ponca Theater and the Ponca City community for the success in our fundraising efforts. Not only attaining our $100,000 goal, but blowing the roof off of it. By your generous giving, we were able to raise $171,395. This has not only allowed us to put a new roof on the building, but enabled us to add much needed waterproofing to the mortar as well. Without you, the patrons of the Ponca Theater, this would never have been achieved. Please take a moment to recognize yourself with a round of applause. Thank you, Ponca patrons. We look forward to many more years of entertaining you in beautiful and beloved Ponca Theater.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to our Thursday night performance of Matilda. Glad you could join us. We are rescheduled, obviously, so normally we tried this two shows in one day thing, and it wore everybody out, so we went away from it, but pulled it old. Rabbit out of the hat to get our fourth show in. So thank you. First of all, thank you to all of you who helped us raise all that money for the roof. It's wonderful to be backstage and not just be sopping wet anytime there's a rainstorm. That's all thanks to you guys. If you would like to continue to give, our next big project, and I mean it's a huge project, bigger than the roof, is to replace these seats that are 35 years old. So that hopefully when you sit in them, you don't take that lurch of death backwards where you have a place to put your drink. So that's the next project. If you'd like to give to that, we would happily take your donation. We've already put the down payment on it, so anything you can do would be great. We'll be grateful for. You can give at the concession stand, or you can see one of the board members who are here tonight. We'll help you with that. Let me thank some other people who we couldn't do this without them. First are our corporate sponsors. They are Kyler Construction Group, Speak Now Productions, Kim's Gym, and Interior Dance. Ponca City Arts and Humanities Council, Merck's Manufacturing, Northern Oklahoma College, the National Endowment for the Arts, the Oklahoma Arts Council, Phillips 66, the Ponca Playhouse, and Shepherd Oil. We also couldn't do it without our volunteers and our parents who are, some of them were taking your tickets or who were serving popcorn or who are backstage pulling on fly rail or helping kids get dressed downstairs. So we couldn't do it without all those people. Can you take a second and thank all of them? Thank you so much. Oh, next up. After this one, it's been moved, but it's still happening. Our next show is 101 Dalmatians. They're deep in rehearsals right now. That's going to happen in March. Luke Garrison is directing that one, and you'll love it. It's going to be adorable. Then next after that is Seussical Junior. The auditions will be at the very end of February for that one, if you'd like to be in Seussical Junior. And then one more. Ryan Smichael is going to be directing The Music Man. That's an Academy show for kids who are looking to get to participate. cap is 12, so it's the younger kids who get a chance to get up here, get some experience, and just have a good time learning something new. So that's Music Man that performs in May, and then we'll end the season with the Addams Family in July. So I hope you come check that out. A couple of things that are going on here. First of all, next Friday, we will be having a sing-along for The Sound of Music. So come check that out. Come sing along and flex those vocal muscles. Then we are doing the classic Citizen Kane. You can come watch that movie on February the 25th. And then on March 4th, the equally classic Magic Mike. But, hey, different demographic. But we cater to all here at Funk Theater. So, and then lastly, this show does have an intermission, so it'll be 10 minutes long. During that time, go get you some more popcorn, visit the concession stand, get some liquor. It makes the second act go by faster. Then we'll start back and do the second half of the show. So when the lights go up, the show's not over. So come back and see us. Thank you guys very much. I know this is sort of a last-minute addition to the schedule because of the weather that we've had. Let me tell you, we tried to put this show on a month ago, and it was like one thing after another. We really thought this winter storm might be the nail in the coffin, but here we are. You guys are here to watch it, and we're ready to perform for you. So please enjoy. Matilda, thanks. Bye.
Listen to this.
Oh, what about me? I've got the whole house.
I'm off to bleach my roots, and I shan't be talking to you for the rest of the evening.
But I'm going to make us rich.
How rich?
Very rich. Russian businessmen, very, very stupid. Your genius husband is going to sell them 150 old bangers as brand new luxury cars.
But that's not fair. The cars will break down. What about the Russians?
Fair? Listen to the boy.
I'm a girl.
Fair does not get you anywhere, you thick-headed twit brain. All I can say is thank heavens Michael has inherited his old man's brains. Eh, son?
Michael.
Well, I shall take the money when you earn it, and I shall spend it, but I shan't enjoy it because of the despicable way in which you have spoken to me tonight.
This is all your fault, with your stupid books and your stupid reading.
That's not right.
You're off to school in a few days, and I know your headmistress, Agatha Trunchbull, scary woman she is, used to compete at the Olympics, throwing the hammer. Imagine what she's going to do to a horrible little goblin like you, boy.
I'm a girl.
Now off to your room, you little bookworm. Man's hair is his greatest asset. A good hair means a good brain.
Your hair! It's green!
My hair's green!
Why on earth did you do that?
Maybe use some of Mommy's peroxide by mistake.
That's exactly what you've done, you stupid man!
My hair, my beautiful, beautiful hair! Oh, I've got my deal today. The Russians. Oh, what am I going to do?
I know what you could do.
What?
You could pretend you're an elf.
What are you talking about? The boy's a loony.
Mum, would you like to hear a story?
No, don't be disgusting. The sooner you're locked up in school, the better.
Mm-hmm.
do love your stories, Matilda. That's a hint, by the way.
Once upon a time, the two greatest circus performers in the world, an escapologist and an acrobat, fell in love and got married.
They performed some of the most incredible feats together, and people would come from miles around.
Kings, queens, celebrities, and astronauts. And not just to see their skill, but also their love for each other.
Which was certainly, as it was said, the cast with her as they walked by, and dogs weep with joy.
They moved into a beautiful old house.
And although they loved each other, they were sad.
Trunchbull's specialty.
My mom says I'm a miracle. My daddy said I would be the dangerous bit.
Oh! Well, it's really fun, according to
today is a very special day. Your first day at school. Now, can anyone read this?
Me. Oh, Miss, I can remember, please, me.
Very well, Nigel. You to burst a blood vessel on your first day. Lavender?
Is the first word tomato?
No. But tomato is a very good word. Matilda?
I can now read words.
So, Matilda, you can read words?
Well, I had to learn how to read words so I could read sentences. Because basically, a sentence is just a big group of words. And if you can't read sentences, you've got no chance with books.
And have you read a whole book yourself?
More than one. I love books. Last week I read quite a few.
A few? What books did you read?
Nicholas Nickleby, Oliver Twist, Jane Eyre, Lord of the Rings, Crime and Punishment, and The Cat in the Hat.
Oh, don't be pathetic. Just knock on the door.
Enter. Well, don't just stand there like a wet tissue. Get on with it.
Oh, yes. Miss Trunchbull, in my class, there's a little girl called Matilda Wormwood.
Daughter of Mr. Harry Wormwood, owner of Wormwood Motors. Excellent, ma'am. Tell me to watch out for that brat there who says she's a real whore.
Oh, no, headmistress. I don't think Matilda's that kind of child at all.
What is the school's motto, Miss Honey?
Bombinatum est magitum.
Bombinatum est magitum. Children are maggots. In fact, it must have been her who placed that stink bomb on my desk. I'll get her for that. Thank you for suggesting it.
But I didn't. Miss Trunchbull, Matilda Wormwood is a genius.
Nonsense!
It is my opinion that this little girl be placed with the 11-year-olds.
We cannot just place her with the 11-year-olds. What kind of society would that be? What about ruse, honey? Ruse?
I believe Matilda Wormwood is an exception to the rules.
An exception? To the rules. In my school. Miss Honey. Look at these trophies. How my trophies gleam in the sunlight. See how they shine. What do you think it took to become English hammer throwing champion? 1969. Think in that moment, when my big moment came, that I treated the ruse with casual disdain. Well, no, 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 no! If you want to throw the hammer for your country, you have to stay inside the circle all the time. And if you want to make the team, you don't need happiness or self-esteem. You just have to keep your feet inside the line. Sing, children! 2, 3, 4!
If you want to go hard enough on your country, you're genius. My key to you have to stay inside the circle all the time. My key to.
And if you want to teach success, you don't need sympathy or
tenderness.
You just have to force the squids to turn the line. Sing, Ginny.
If you want to throw the hammer for your country, you have to stay inside the circle all the time.
I apply just one simple rule to hammer throwing life at school. So learn to throw it, find a volley, line and throw it, and always keep your feet inside. Now get out!
Mistress, I hope you know that it is my intention
these cars were knackered. I told them the mileage is so high because of a manufacturing mistake.
So you lied?
Of course I lied.
And they didn't believe you?
Of course they didn't believe me. I have green hair.
I've got hair?
And what's this? Another flaming book? What's wrong with the telly?
No, it's a lovely book. You should read it. I think you...
Here's what I think of your lovely.
No! No, please don't! No, please, it's a library book! Please don't rip it!
Oh, you showed the little brat! I'm gonna be late for my dance lesson with Rodolfo!
Now get off to your bed, you little stinkworm!
Do we have any super glue?
In the cupboard. Hey, and while you're at it, why don't you stick your stupid book to your stupid head?
Ah, that's a good one. I like that.
Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You must let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let the kid on top you, might as well be sign. You think that it's okay, and that's not right.
I've got my eye on you, boy.
I'm a girl. Give you a headache? I mean, they got to hurt or squish your neck.
No, it's fine. I think they just fit.
Well, I'd better stick around just in case they start to, you know, squeeze out of your ears. I'm Lavender, and I think it's probably for the best if we're best friends.
My face! Someone put a whole can of treacle onto Trenchville's chair. Someone told her I did it, and now she's after me.
That's not fair.
Once the Trenchville decides you're guilty, you're squished.
They're saying she's going to put me in chokey.
What's chokey?
They say it's a cupboard in her office that she throws children into and finds with nails and spikes
and bits of broken glass.
There's a place you are sent if you haven't been good, and it's made of spikes and wood, and it isn't wide enough to sit, and even if you could, there are nails on the bottom, so you wish you stood. When the hinge is creaky and the door is closed, you cannot see squat from the end of your nose, and if you scream, you don't know if the sound came out or if the scream in your head even reached your mouth.
Well, when did this happen?
About 20 minutes ago. Why? She's coming!
You better hide. Quick, sweaters!
Please don't tell her I'm into the shelf.
Now!
Where is the maggot known as Nar Jail?
He's over there, under this coat, where he's been for the last hour, actually.
What? An hour?
Yes. Nigel suffers from a rare but chronic sleeping disorder, narcolepsy. The sufferer falls asleep without any warning. We put him under the coats for safety, didn't we? Didn't we?
Yes.
He'll probably think he's in bed when he wakes up.
Is it time for school yet, Mommy? Where am I? This
What have I told you about pigtails?
I hate pigtails!
Your mum.
He's a twit! You! What is your name? You have just made a very big mistake.
Just so you all know, she is my best friend.
Yes, sir. Completely different class, sir. Yeah, green hair? Yeah, it's National Green Hair Day, a celebration of all the wonderful green things in the world, like lettuce and snot. Tomorrow at 1, sir. Absolutely, sir. Bye-bye, sir. Ooh. Now that is how you do. I'm gonna leave this on. Looks like rain.
Interruptions due to my energy flow.
What do you want, Miss Chutney?
It's actually Miss Honey. Well, as you know, Matilda's in the bottom class right now, and children in the bottom class aren't really expected to read, but...
Oh! Then stop the reading! Girls should not be reading.
I'm in the zone, doll! I can feel it in my hips. Don't waste this.
I'm not in favour of girls being all clever pants, Miss Hussey. Looks are more important than books. Now, look at you, and look at me. You chose books, and I chose looks.
I'm on fire.
I don't think you understand. Matilda can calculate complicated figures in her mind in an instant.
Calculate this!
Her mind is incredible. With a little bit of help from us, I think she could be amazing.
Her mind? Her mind! Oh, you really don't know anything, do you?
Somewhere along the way, my dear, you made an awful error. You oughtn't blame yourself now. Come along. Okay. You seem to think that people like people when I'm clever. It's very quaint or it's very sweet, but wrong. People don't like smarty pants when round claiming that they know stuff we don't know.
Here's a tip.
What you know
matters less
than the volume with which what you don't know is expressed. Content
has never been less important.
So you have got to be loud. Girl, you've got to learn to stand up, stick out from the crowd. A lot more fear, a little less brain, a lot more fear, a little less hurt, a lot more tear.
Everybody loves a little something exotic.
But living a life with is over the top.
Doesn't really matter what you don't know about.
Not if you just take it with a bit of clout.
The less you have to say, the louder you yell it, the less you have to show. The louder you dress it, the dumber the act. The bigger the confession, the less you have to say, the louder you yell it. You've got to get up. You've got to get up and be
gentlemen, boys and girls, the burning woman hurling through the air with dynamite in her hair over sharks and spiky objects, caught by the man locked in the cage, has been cancelled.
No!
Cancelled because my wife is pregnant.
So it does have a happy ending.
No, because just then, contract.
I have paid for the publicity, the posters, the catering, the toilet facilities. Where is my profit? A contract is a contract. You shall perform on this day, or off to prison you both shall go.
No, no! What happens next?
I don't know. I'll tell you tomorrow.
of very clever books that will challenge your mind. You may sit and read them while I teach the others. And if you have any questions, well, I shall do my best to answer them. How does that sound? Matilda, why, this is the biggest hug in the world. You're going to hug all the air out of me.
Matilda Wormwood! Where is?
Yes, Miss Trunchbull.
Aha, so you admit it, do you?
Admit what, Miss Trunchbull?
This morning, Miss Val Carbuncle sneaked like a serpent into the kitchen and took my private chocolate cake off my tea tray.
No, I did not.
Miss Trunchbull, Matilda's been here all morning.
Standing up for this spitball, are we? Well, this crime took place before school started. Therefore, she is guilty!
Okay, look, I stole the cake. And honestly, I was really definitely sort of almost thinking about owning up, maybe. But I was having a lot of trouble with my belly. The Trunchbull's cake was so good that it's got the dead tooth with me, and now it's beginning to fight back! See?
You are a thief and a crook, and I shall crush you!
A huge cloud of chocolatey gas wafted from my mouth, and it came falling to the face of the Trunchbull!
Bruce Bogtrotter.
Yes,
you enjoyed my cake, didn't you, Bruce?
Well, yes, Miss Trunchbull. And I'm
very... Oh, as long as you enjoyed it, that's the main thing.
Is it?
Yes, Bob Trotter. It is.
Well, I did. Thank you.
Wonderful. Marvelous. That makes me so happy it gives me a warm glow in my lower intestine. Oh, what's the matter, Bogtrotter? Lost your appetite?
Well, yes, I'm full!
You're not full until I say you. And I say criminals like yourself are not full until you've eaten the entire cake. Eat!
A single slice, or even two, Bruce.
Carried away sometimes, even myself. Well done, Bogtrotter. Good show. Well, come along, Bogtrotter.
What? Where?
Who did I not mention? That was the first part of your punishment. There's more.
the second part. And the second part is...
Chocolate!
What? No, Miss Trunchbull, please, you can't!
Do you really think I would allow myself to be bested by these maggots? Who do you think I am, Miss Hunt? A weakling? An idiot?
You!
No, no! No, don't take it!
You can go right on ahead.
Come on, come on, come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
pants became slippy, and she fell.
Did she survive?
She lived long enough to have a child, and she also broke every bone in her body, except for the ones at her little fingers.
Love our daughter with all your heart. She is all we ever wanted.
Gather round, everyone. I want my family to share my triumph. Not you, boy.
I'm a girl.
155 old bangers on my hands. How could I possibly make the mileage go back? I couldn't very well drive each one backwards, could I?
Backwards!
When suddenly, I had the most genius idea. I grabbed a drill, and using my incredible mind, I attached the drill to the speedometer of the first car.
That... what?
Exactly. Within a few minutes, the car's mileage has been reduced to practically nothing.
Backwards!
10 minutes later, the Russians show up. Expensive suits, dark glasses.
Russians are nocturnal. I saw that on a program last night.
That program was about badges.
Same thing. And? Work?
Voila!
Fantastico! Now I can afford Rodolfo all day long!
But they've trusted you, and you've cheated them.
What have we done to deserve a child like you?
You know what I'm going to do? Tomorrow I'll go to that school of yours and tell your teacher you're never to be let in again.
What?
And if she does, I'll have her fired. You will never, ever read another stinking book as long as you live, young man.
I'm a girl.
Now go to your room. You must be little creep.
The box!
The Escapologist's daughter suffered in silence, never saying a single word about her evil aunt's bully. But that only encouraged the woman to greater cruelties. Until one day, she exploded.
You are filthy, nasty, useless little...
And beat her and threw her in a deep, dank, dusty cellar. Locked the door and went out.
Have I been so wrapped up in my grief for my wife that I have forgotten what mattered to us most? I love you so much, I shall spend the rest of my life making it up to you.
And when the little girl fell asleep, the Escapologist's thoughts turned back to the acrobat sister.
Bullying children is her game, is it? Then let us see what she can do when the wrath of a grown man stands before her.
Books, woman.
They're for Matilda.
Not on my watch. There's an age for reading, and there's an age for being a useless little toad. These are toads, aren't you, Bog Trotter?
Yes, Miss Trenchwell. Only Bog Trotter now is a good toad.
Sit! You believe in kindness and fluffiness in books and stories. That is not teaching. To teach the child, we must first break the child. Quiet, you mullets!
But, Miss Trenchbull, no one was speaking.
Miss Honey, when I say quiet, you mullets, you are entirely included in that statement. Where is my jug of water?
I'll get it, Miss Trenchbull.
Stupid girls. Look at you. Flabby, disgusting, revolting. Revolting, I say! I think it's time that we toughen you all up with a little bit of fizz air. This school of late has started reeking. Quiet, my guitar, I'm speaking! Reeking with a most disturbing scent. Only the finest nostrils smell it, but I know it oh too well. It is the odor of rebellion. It's the bulking of dissent. And you can bet your britches this headmistress finds this foul defarescence wholly olfactorily insulting. And so to stop the stench's spread, I find a session of fizz air sorts the merely rain from the revolting. The smell of rebellion comes out in the sweat, and fizz air will get you sweating, and it won't be long before I smell the palm of aiding and abetting. A bit of fizz air will tell it you has a handful of rebellious thoughts. Hold, hold! Just like a rotten egg floats to the top of a bucket of water. The smell of rebellion, the stench of revolt, the roar of insubordination, the whiff of resistance, the pull of dissent, the fall of mutiny and action. Before a weed becomes too big and greener, you really need to nip it in the bud. Position two. Before the word starts to fall, you must scrape off the dirt and rip it from the mud. The whiff of incense, the pull of dissent, the fall of mutiny and action. The waft of fire, the odor of fuel, the pull of prepubescent protest. Once we've exercised these demons, there shall be two boots for scheming. Some double time discipline should stop the rot from setting in. All right, let's step it up. Double time. Discipline, discipline for children who aren't listening. The midgets who are fidgeting and twittering in this room. The spittering and spattering and tempering and tampering is tampered with the spammering of discipline. We must begin insisting on rigidity and discipline, persistently resisting this anarchistic mischief in this minute you are pandering and frittering, while little ones like this, they just want discipline! The simpering is bittering, the tempering and tampering, the misigning the tissue is an issue we can fix. There is no mystery to mastering the art of passion, mistress. It's discipline, discipline. The smell of rebellion, the stench of revolt, the reek of prepubescent quality, the whip of the resistance, the odor of cure, the funk of moral barbarity. Imagine a world of fiction. Close your eyes and just dream. Imagine, give a shot, the peace and the quiet of Berlin Street. Now imagine a woods with a cottage. And inside that cottage we find a dwarf, can't see, a carnival freak. He's invoking the hats with his mind, and he says, don't let them steal your horses, and don't let them take them away. If you find your way through, they'll be waiting for you, singing, run, run. said, the stinking maggot rears its head. Even the squirtiest, piteous mess can harvest seeds of stinkiness. Have you ever seen anything more repellent? Have you ever smelt anything worse than the smell of rebellion? The stench of revolt, the recurrence of ordination, the whiff of resistance, the palm of dissent. And I will not stop till you are squashed, till this rebellion is quashed, till glorious sweat and discipline has washed its innocent away. There's a newt in my knickers! There's a newt in my knickers! Oh, right! It's heading north! Oh! 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 Oh!
Well, that was interesting. I think we'd all better go home while we still can. Matilda?
Watch.
And begged him to let me move in. He thought I'd gone mad, but he agreed, and I've lived here ever since.
But I don't understand. You can't live in a shed, though.
I'm not strong like you, Matilda. My father died when I was young. Magnus was his name, and he was very kind. But when he was gone, my aunt became my legal guardian. She was mean and cruel like you could hardly imagine. And when I got my job as a teacher, she presented me with a bill for looking after me all those years. She'd written everything down, every tea bag, every electricity bill, every tin of beans. And she made me sign a contract to pay her back every penny. She even produced a document that said my father had given her his entire house.
But did he really just give her his entire house?
I find it hard to believe. Just like I cannot believe that he would have just killed himself, which is what she said happened.
You think she did him in, don't you, Miss Honey?
I cannot say, but all I know is that years of being bullied by that woman has made me, well, pathetic. I was trapped.
So that's why you live here?
This roof keeps me dry when the rain falls. This door helps to keep the cold at bay. On this floor I can stand on my own two feet. On this chair I can
that she was capable of murder.
But why? She shouted at you, she beat you, she threw you in tiny cupboards.
Matilda, stop, please.
Who is she?
A punch after the punch after the punch.
Miss Trunchbull.
Is going to have a very special spelling test. Any student who gets one single answer wrong will go to choke it! What are you staring at?
You. You. Spell. Oh, now, let's see. Spell Newt.
Newt. N-E-W-T. Newt.
What?
Miss Honey taught us. She's very good at teaching.
Nonsense. You! Stand up, turn around, and spell the one thing you all are. Revolting.
R-E-V-O-L-T-I-N-G. Revolting.
You're cheating!
I've taught them. That's it. With patience and kindness and respect.
How dare you bring those words into my classroom, madam? You know nothing of teaching in our shampoo. You. Spell, let's see. Spell armchair-be-be-be-moses.
But that's not a word! You just made it up!
Spell it, or go to choke. And I shall warn you, it has silent letters.
A-N-C-H-E-L-L-A.
Oh dear. Oh dearie, dearie, dear. I'm sorry, it was a silent Z. You're going to choke it!
Banana.
Bully. X-P-Y-W-B. Bully.
Revolting!
hand up, and that I was now the owner of the beautiful old house that had been previously owned by my evil aunt, one Agatha Trunchbull.
Who was never seen again, and the trophies were immediately destroyed, and the new headmistress took over.
And her name was Miss Honey, and it was often said that it was the best school in all the land.
Matilda was never again able to move things with her eyes. She said it was because she no longer had a use for special powers, but she was still stuck with parents who were mean and cruel and called her names.
Don't just stand there, gaping. We're going to Spain, and we're never coming back.
Spain? Why?
Because this twit brain decided to sell 5,555 old bangers to the Russian mafia.
They're here. Hide.
What the damage to my legs? What beautiful legs! There is your father. The vanguard is a stupid man and assumed I was stupid too, which is a very stupid and rude thing to do.
But I'm afraid my father is very rude and very, very stupid.
You seem smart. Sadly, in my line of work, I don't often meet smart people like you. Most of the people I deal with, the thinking is all backwards.
Backwards!
I can have some of my friends cede your father some manners, and when he leaves his hospital, he will still be rude, but not so stupid. What do you think?
It's a very tempting offer, but I think I've had enough revenge.
Your father is very lucky to have you as his daughter.
I beg your pardon.
Mr. Wormwood, I would love to take care of Matilda. I would look after her with patience and respect, and I'd pay for everything.
So you mean leave our daughter here with you?
Dad, you call me your daughter.
And do you want to stay with Miss Honey?
Yes, I do.
And do you want to look after her?
I do.
Well, we're a bit short of room, so yes.
Thank you.
And Matilda leapt into Miss Honey's arms.
And hugged her.
And Miss Honey hugged her back. And they hardly noticed as the Wormwoods.
And Rodolfo.
As the Wormwoods and Rodolfo sped away into